What's up, guys? It's your boy Paul. I'm back with you. This is Rideout Reviews, and today we are watching the movie We Are Soldiers. So I'm not quite sure what era or war this is. World War II, Vietnam, maybe. I'm not quite sure. But I do know that Mel Gibson directed this movie, man. And Mel Gibson is a wonderful, phenomenal director. And I've heard so much about how good this movie is that it is like really worth the watch. And so definitely glad that I'm getting a chance to watch it, and I want to experience more. I've been watching Band of Brothers here lately, and check it out. If you want full reactions, go ahead to Patreon. But and it's a wonderful series, man. It really captures a lot about war, the efforts so far that I've watched, like just preparing for war, then the brotherhood behind the war. But really, it gives you like an introspection, if that's the word. Maybe it's more like a view of more of an understanding of war from a personal standpoint. The last episode I watched just had me so like I was there, you know, in a sense. And it was a different like I was there. It was a way that I probably feel I might be when I was there. You know what I'm saying? That's how amazing that show is the perspectives and the story and how they tell it. But anyway, these war movies have been cool, and yeah, I'm excited to watch this one to see what's going on. Like I said before, I think in Saving Private Ryan, man, that I haven't really watched war movies or TV shows, and I've been watching a lot here lately. So yeah, this has been quite an eye-opening experience. So I appreciate you guys, because that's what movies do, though. They plant you into places that you might necessarily not be. So it gives you a better perspective of the lives of others, man. And that's a powerful thing about movies, is that they show you who people are without you having to be those people, so that you can have some sort of empathy for them, man. And so it makes me just understand a whole culture that I would never be a part of, because that's just not what I've done in my life, you know. And so I've been around people that are in war, but not anybody that really is open and willing to talk about something like this. And so being able to watch these movies gives me a peek inside the psyche of those types of people, man. So I enjoy it and I appreciate it. Anyway, if you guys want to check out the full reaction, man, head over to my Patreon. Would love to see you there. You know what I'm saying? Watch some of the full reactions, the exclusives, the YouTube early releases, as well as you can comment and do a lot of things there where we can convo about these movies that we've been watching. If not, man, hey, I appreciate you for being here, because, you guys have some great comments, man. So I'm looking forward to reading these and discussing what you guys think of this movie, and just the psyche and mentality of whatever goes on. I'm not sure how this plays out, but, you know, just the brotherhood and all that stuff that you see in war. Because people are different after it, man. And I feel like when they come out of it, that they are closer with the people who were there than they ever will be with other people, you know. So anyway, yeah, appreciate that, man. And I'm gonna go ahead and start the movie, man. Let's go ahead and watch the movie, guys.
Maybe in June of 1954, when French group Mobile 100 moved into the same central highlands of Vietnam.
Yeah, this is definitely gonna be a different type. I know Vietnam is different than World War II, so it's gonna be a different story.
Putain de chaleur. Putain de pays.
Dude! Dang. They snuck up on them dudes, man.
Chúng ta có bắt giữ tù binh không?
Không. Giết sạch bọn chúng. Để không cho chúng ta đi nữa.
Dang. That's like against rules of war, ain't it? No prisoners. Thinking about this being Vietnam, I don't know if it has anything to do with it, but saying we are soldiers seems like, hey, man, there was more to us in this thing going on than just, having to get sent over there, that we were soldiers regardless of how we got there, what we did.
Hal Moore. He led a combat company in Korea. After that, he volunteered to test experimental parachutes.
Experimental parachutes? Sounds like just the guy.
Experimental parachutes? That is kind of weird.
Hey, how about we go back to bingo? What do you say? Oh. Bingo!
I don't want daddy's boots.
How much you know about our new colonel? He was in Korea, has a master's in international relations from Harvard.
From Harvard?
Hey, Coulson! That's Coulson, man. Yeah, I don't look up much on any of these movies before I watch them, so I wonder if this is a true story. Oh, wait. It just said based upon a book. It didn't say if it was a true story or not, but I wonder if it is. Oh, I guess Mel Gibson didn't direct this one. It was somebody else who did it. But Mel Gibson's a good actor, too.
You're out of state shit! No wonder you can't fly! You can't see it!
I believe you're out.
Lieutenant Colonel! Dang!
You're a pilot?
Too tall, sir.
Yeah, I can see that.
Yeah. You call, we haul.
He said, too tall, sir. Yeah, you can see that. That brother tall. He about shoulders, chest high than them dudes.
Why else? They want to fly with you for some reason. I guess it's because they think you're the best.
I suppose I have a choice in all this.
You sure don't.
Dang. But the best want to do the best. You want to be the best. I don't got a choice in this, do I? You sure don't.
Good morning, Sergeant Major.
How do you know what kind of goddamn day it is?
Oh, golly. He said, how do you know what type of day it is? Ooh, that boy. Those little things, this must be the wars he fought in. He got a police officer in Korea.
This will be our horse.
That's pretty maneuverable. He came in, touched down, took off. Right, choppers are pretty maneuverable.
Sergeant Major Plumley and I come from the paratroopers, where the officer is always the first one out of the plane. Inspire your men by your example. You have to be with them.
The officers, they like the sergeants and all that stuff.
Now, I hope you gentlemen like training, because me and the Sergeant Major, we love it.
Sergeant Major, he looking like he get pretty old. But he be getting down. World War II and Korea. Bro, that gun'll chop a man in half.
Alright! Your officer's dead! What do you do? What do you do? Alright! He hesitated, he's dead! What do you do?
Get off the chopper!
Get off of the
Get off the chopper! That's what we do, is get off the chopper.
You learn the job of the man above you, and you teach your job to the man below you in rank. That goes for every man in this outfit, understood?
Yes, sir!
Hey. Hey, that's real talk, man.
I don't want to be Catholic. I want to be Methodist like Mommy.
You do?
What?
And why is that, honey?
So I can play whatever I want.
I'm a Methodist. I couldn't tell. Must be a Methodist. That's one thing about old Mel Gibson and all his movies, man. He be having some Christian stuff in there, man.
Good morning, Sergeant Major.
Are you a fucking weatherman now?
Take care of your men. Teach them to take care of each other, because when this starts, each other is all we're going to have.
That's real talk, man. That is real talk.
I like this. Some bitches calls me Grandpa. I tell you.
It's like, he ain't calling the old warrior Grandpa here, huh? Dang. I like that concept, though, man. He's so right, dude. It's like, hey, you got to build that camaraderie, that brotherhood. And not only that, but you got to teach it to your officers, or not your officers, to your soldiers. Because he's their officers. Like, the reason that's the way it is because that's all they got, man. Dang.
Want you to draw fresh socks from supply. Keep your feet dusted with powder.
Now that young man's a leader.
Yes, sir. That other feller, that big strong one there, he wants to win medals.
I got one as a leader, taking people's feet off and checking them, man, caring for ourselves. Other one wants to win medals, man. He's training these dudes.
The laundromat in town's okay, but they won't let you wash your colored things in their machine. I'm telling you, they have a big sign right in the window says whites only.
Oh, snap.
What?
Honey, they mean white people only.
Dang.
That's awful.
But I know what my husband's fighting for, and that's why I can smile. My husband will never ask for respect. And he'll give respect to no man who hasn't earned it. The rest of his family is the same way. And anybody who doesn't respect that can keep his goddamn washing machine, because my baby's clothes are going to be clean anyway.
Dang. Man, that's crazy. How she not realize that? Boy. Man, that woman, though, she's strong, dude. That's why that man could be strong in this situation, because she's strong. That's awesome. But dang. And that is insane. A brother could go die for his country and be treated as disrespectful in it.
Tanger already? What's that say?
Oh, Camille. Yeah, I'm sorry about this.
No, don't
sir.
You take that off. You leave that on where it is. That's an order.
Hey, I like that. He said, you leave that on. That's an order.
What do you think about being a soldier and a father?
I hope that being good at the one makes me better at the other.
Barbara and I spent a year in Africa. We helped build a school for orphans. They were orphans because the warlord across the border didn't like their tribe. I know God has a plan for me. I just hope it's to help protect orphans, not make any.
Well, why don't we ask him? Come on, let's go ask him.
Hey, that's real talk, man. That is definitely real talk.
Father in heaven.
A real thing that could
before
happen.
Before we go into battle, you use me as your instrument in this awful hell of war to watch over them. Especially if there are men like this one beside me deserving of a future in your blessing and goodwill.
I didn't even think of it like that.
Oh, yes, and one more thing, dear Lord. About our enemies, ignore their heathen prayers and help us blow those little bastards straight to hell.
Oh, my. I don't think he was playing either. Dang, that's funny. Oh, but that's crazy, though, think not make him. And he's talking about himself, but at the same time, he's also talking about those kids, the people that he's going to be warring against, because they're fathers, too. Dang, well, he is study. He's a studier of war. He is a, what would you call that? A student of war. He's learning. And about the place that he's going to. Not just random, which it's not random, but still.
I have today ordered to Vietnam the Air Mobile Division.
Get out your best dresses, ladies. They're gonna want to celebrate.
Because it's the last time they're gonna see their families for a while. Because they know it ain't a celebration. But that's what they're gonna call it.
Well, without that declaration, it means our enlistments won't be extended.
I'm sorry, Hal.
Oh, forgive me, sir, but let me get this straight. We form a division using techniques that have never been attempted in battle against an enemy with 20 years of combat experience on his ground. And right before the Army sends us into the fight, they take away a third of my men, the most experienced third, including the officers.
Woo! Oh, so these are airborne Rangers, huh? These are the guys that were sent behind line, enemy lines in World War II. Same kind of people that were on Band of Brothers. This is the commission, or this is the unit, same type of unit.
They're renumbering the units. You're now the commanding officer of the 1st Battalion of the 7th Cavalry.
Same regiment as Custer. Sure.
Dang. It's like, it's saying either giving him a glorious name, or are they saying that he's way outnumbered? Yeah, he's not supposed to take that as an honor or as a dishonor. Not a dishonor, but as like, hey, you may not make it. Man, that's a life, man, when you know that you got to sign your will over, get your life insurance, because you may not be coming back. That is tough, man. That's a reality, too, for men that go over to war. Is it the same way for people that are deployed today? For people when they send them over to Afghanistan? I would think so. Or Iraq or wherever they go. Man. That's a heavy burden. And they do it knowing that they could... It could be the last time to see their family. That's some brave men. Some brave men and women.
Some men may experience discrimination because of race or creed, but for you and me now, all that is gone. So let us understand the situation. We are going into battle against a tough and determined enemy. I will be the first to set foot on the field, and I will be the last to step off, and I will leave no one behind. Dead or alive, we will all come home together. So help me God.
Man, this show is definitely about the power of leadership, I'll tell you that, man. The power of leadership, man. That was a wonderful speech. He's a good leader. And he's not only there to be a leader, but he wants to make good leaders. And that's the best kind of leader to have. Not only just being a leader, but making good leaders. And that's why I said, he helps being both, helps him to be better at being both, or one helps him be better at the other. Because, man, that's really what a father is a leader. To be the best leader, he's got to be a good father. The Bible says, how can you lead others if you can't take care of your own household? How can you manage another place? And he manages both, his household and the squadron, the regiment. Leaving in the dead of night, man. Some don't even get a chance to wake up. Well, I'm sure they all are awake. Because they all knew this time was happening. I say that, and she comes out. Don't even get a chance to say goodbye. Because of when they have to leave.
What do you estimate the enemy strength?
We appraise their numbers as manageable, Colonel.
As manageable?
We have no idea. We have no idea.
That's insane.
Campus, no casualties. They're running hide in the mountains. So naturally, we chase them, of course. They smell like an ambush to you.
They get close enough to kill us, we'll be close enough to kill them.
That is crazy. They don't kill anybody. They hide, and they expect us to chase them.
The first 60 men on the ground will be there a half hour alone. I think maybe you ought to get yourself that M16.
Time comes when I need one, sir, there'll be plenty of them lying on the ground.
Oh, man, that is not a good thing. I mean, they're going to be plenty dead. Jeez. He said there'll be plenty lying on the ground if I need one. Jeez. How do people send, how do you send them out into stuff like this? This is an ambush. How do you send, I don't know, that's insane. This is what they've trained for. The helicopter soldiers. The helicopter soldiers, man. They've been planning for this. The first one down. You know, they just firing. There's nobody around. About wasting ammo. They just want to protect themselves on their landing.
It's a scout! Let's take him prisoner! Lieutenant!
Wrong move, man. I know that's gotta be the wrong move. He drawing him in.
Say mommy had destroyed French. Did he say they want to kill American very badly? Did not been able to find any yet.
Take the radio!
Yeah, they got ambushed, man. That scout took off running so they could shoot Americans. And they're behind them. They surrounded them.
Grab the wounded, we'll make a run! Sir! We gotta get out of here! Stay down! Fuck us, stay down!
Dang. So he's the leader now. He said, you better stay down. And he's the one that wanna win medals.
Stay down! Hey, calm down! Understand the situation and communicate
clearly. Oh, man. He's like standing with shots around him talking about calm down. And he got a doggone light just blasted off. Oh, they brought more soldiers in.
We gotta go. We're out of here.
And they brought that deserter back to base.
I'm glad I could die for my country.
I saw them eyes dilating, man. That ain't no joke. Dang, he blew out his leg off.
They're right on top of us, sir! Bring it in close!
Wow. I didn't know that they were that accurate with them type of mortars, I guess. I guess those are like mortars, artillery. This is accurate and continuous. Man, I didn't realize that they could do that accurate with them. They are. They went into a trap. They planned this. Because they wanted to take out American soldiers. So they planned this attack to draw them in. Man, and America went for it. What do they want to show their strength to? What did America just follow the plan for?
The wounded are over by that termite mound. Go! If you don't find some cover, you're going to go down. If you go down, we all go down. Come on!
He said, man, you've got to stay alive because you the boss. We can listen to you. Oh.
That creek bed is vital. Vital. Get out of here. They'll be coming right at you. Do not let them flank.
Do not let them flank. See, that's... He knows what he's doing, man. That's why he is there. He did that studying of the terrain so he can know what to expect. Dang, that is... Every time I watch these movies or these TV shows about military and I see the strategy behind it all, it amazes me, man. These guys are, they are some smart people that are in these positions.
Requesting immediate close air support. I need you to burn them out on Hilltop Alpha. Ship.
As soon as that thing came, oh, they got the, F-16s, too. Oh, jets. And that's amazing that the Army got them ready, too. As soon as they call, it happens. Instantaneously. They call for it.
Watch our approach, follow us in.
Oh dang! And they've got the medical helicopters.
Hey, get out of here! Bring me the wounded! Wounded! Get the wounded!
Ah, I was telling him to get out, but he's like, I gotta take some of these wounded, man.
That LZ, we've all had it. Can you hold? Where's breakfast?
Landing zone, LZ. They got a lot of soldiers, too. And they just keep coming. What did they say, 4,000?
I call losing a load of draftees a bad week. Losing a colonel's a massacre.
Moore is still fighting. They're not lost. They're only cut off and surrounded.
And he's a colonel, lieutenant colonel. That's a massacre. That's high ranking.
Colonel, we've blown a new LZ.
And when you come in from the east.
Hey, they made a new landing zone, man. Oh, he's still out there with his arm shot.
Just you. Saigon wants to debrief you.
That doesn't make any sense.
That don't make any sense.
Two-tall, follow the colonel to the new LZ. I say a strike.
So follow the colonel. Dang, he's flying over him, moving with him to the new LZ. That's because they want to take him off. But he ain't leaving. Daggum, man.
That's the last of it.
Dang, they got cut off from their whole crew because they ran after that scout. What the? Oh, snap. What did that dude throw?
You hit? No, I'm okay. Our guys are gonna come for us, aren't they?
Yeah.
They're like, dude.
We in a bad place, man. We in a hard place with this one. You could just see it in their face. They defeated before they even go in. That's tough.
I want you to go over there and reinforce the ship on that ridge there. Look.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Which one would be worse, to be already down there in a firefight or knowing you going down to this firefight, man? One that don't look like you winning.
We got to break through to that cutoff platoon.
They going this time.
You got enough room for one more. If you're crazy enough, get in.
He's like, dude, this is a kill zone. People just getting murked out here. If you want to get in, then let's go. Man, and it's out to dark, man. They've been out there till dark. Jeez. That's got to be scary, too. I didn't see all that. Just trying to get in a position to land.
Where are you from, son?
Imperial, Texas, sir.
Well, that's the first thing I heard all day that makes any sense.
Them Texans, man, they come down. I saw a homeboy from Saving Private Ryan. He was a sniper. The reporter.
You led my men into a hot LZ.
Yeah, somebody had to flay out the wounded.
No, no, don't you play hot shot with
me. Got the balls to face me, but not the balls to face the enemy.
Right.
Hey. He's like, calm that down, man. Woo. Right. He said, you can come to me, but you can't go out there. But he's down. He said, you call me, you need me, you call me, man. Oh, snap. Oh, my gosh, dude.
Previously established targets, Alpha, Bravo, and Charlie.
Dang, bro. He was right. I could smell him rolling up on me, man. He said, illuminate. They were just standing right there. Golly. Yeah, I'm guessing this is a true story. When they got the time and stuff coordinated, this is the first actual battle between Americans and the Vietnam.
We gave them more than they gave us today. Keep it up. How you boys doing?
That's a colonel, man. Lieutenant Colonel.
Sir, I need a confirmed count of our dead and wounded. I got to know where all my boys are.
You'll get it, Al.
We want to bury our wounded. We want to bury our dead. He gonna bring all them buddies home. All them soldiers home. Because they deserve it.